made by Judy Jamerson. Judy is a Bay Area native, born in San Jose, grew up in Belmont, and lived by the ocean and in San Francisco, and now in the East Bay. Drawing is something she has always liked to do. When she was a child, her father was an award-winning newspaper photographer. In his books, photographs of dancer Martha Graham by Barbara Morgan and the famous Milk Drop Crowd by Harold Egerton influenced her aesthetic sense. In the early 70s, she was a founding member of the Priscilla Ives Mural Center. She learned painting up against the wall. While she was involved in a community mural project, she started painting canvases on her own. She worked as a landscape gardener and was involved in the community garden program in San Francisco and has a garden of her own. As a painter, she seems to be drawn to plant natural forms, the unfolding of new growth, and the motion of waves. She thinks of her paintings as being evocative rather than representative. Just one moment before Judy comes up, I just want to introduce one of our artists. Can you raise your hand, Suzanne Cerny? And without further ado, Judy Jamerson.
So that was pretty much a condensed story there. I don't know what, I guess I could fill in some details. My first painting experiences was doing mural projects. So does anybody remember the CETA program where there was, all of a sudden there was money available for art projects, and a friend of mine got a grant to do a mural on the side of the school. It was like four stories tall, and she said, "Hey, you want to help?" I said, "Sure," not knowing what I was getting into. So we had scale drawings, and we had a five-decker scaffold that we had to climb up and from a inch square, put a drawing into 3 feet grids on a wall, which actually turned out to be really easy and fun, and that kind of got kind of hooked on painting from that experience. But it turns out I'm not really good at coming up with images on demand to fit a specific location or theme that somebody else wants you to do. So I started doing my own work, and I'd been involved in photography for decades before, so my whole sense of form and composition is really influenced by my work in photography. And my work in gardening, the forms, the diversity of plant forms is so amazing when you watch a thing from a seed pod and form from a blossom and watch the thing flower and die and then reproduce. And these kind of forms really fascinate me, and mostly that's what I work on. I never work on anything specific, a specific form, but rather kind of generally. In my work, there's a lot of things that are kind of going to morph into something else, or they're going to bloom or move something. And I paint with acrylics, and since I'm not trained as a painter, I don't really have a background in technical stuff, so I like to work in real thin washes of acrylics and then kind of build it up as I go along, and that seems to work for me. And I like to do a lot of shading, and I can't seem to do flat planes. I'm always rounding things off and shading them. I don't know why. No rational reason for it. I just like to do that. So anybody have any questions?
Where are your paintings?
Where? Oh, these two right here. Actually, this one is done from an actual thing. It was a photograph somebody sent me on a card of some form of coral, and the image had a lot more turns in it, and it was just such an amazing form with all these lines and everything that I decided to try and paint a little piece of it just to see how it went. Any more questions?
How about your largest painting?
This one here, or?
No, how about that?
The biggest one I've done is about
like that. Besides the building, of course.
Yeah, after working on a building, I kind of tend to like to paint big. You kind of get immersed in it. You know, it's all around you. Get in it. Yeah. like to paint at nighttime, put some jazz on the radio, and just don't bother me for a few hours and just go. Sometimes that the people have mentioned the creative process and spirituality in art, and every now and then when I'm painting, I get into a groove where I feel like I almost can't make a mistake. It's like, probably everybody knows this feeling once in a while when it's like flowing through you, and it's not you doing it, it's a process, and you're just, you get caught up in the stream of it, and it's really wonderful when it happens like that.